Aloha. You're watching Ericsson Enterprise Wireless Demo Series, where we get hands-on how-to from the Ericsson experts. And I'm really excited today to have Colin Geis on. He's our lead product manager for IoT and mobility solutions. Thanks for joining me today, Colin.
Thank you so much, Peter. It's awesome to be here.
Nice to have you. It's always fun to get the lead product managers on to talk about their areas of focus. And today, a little bit different, we're talking about some new hardware, aren't we, Colin?
We are. And this is almost like Christmas in the middle of, the end of August here. We are really thrilled. The team has pulled together a phenomenal product, and I'm just proud to be here to present it.
Sweet. And we're going to do a little fun unboxing. But before we do that, you want to talk a little bit about, so these new pieces of hardware really focus on IoT solutions, don't they?
It is. So what we have here is the Ericsson Cradlepoint IoT portfolio from the bottom to the top, kind of entry level to highest performance. And what I want to convey here is where this new product is going to fit within the portfolio. So starting at the entry level point is our new S400, which we're going to be unboxing and talking about a bit more today. Just above that is the big brother, the S700, which has been out for about a year and a half. Also the 920, one of our Cat 7 ruggedized products. Above that is our R980. For the viewers, we should jump over to a different video, which will be coming out shortly, to check out that one. And then rounding out the top of the portfolio is our all-in-one R2100 router antenna combo.
Yeah, so what Colin was mentioning, we're also going to do an unboxing for the R980. And when that comes out, we'll put a link for that here in the description of this video. So what are some of these IoT use cases that our routers support here?
So Cradlepoint has traditionally focused on enterprise IoT sorts of applications, kiosks, digital signage, video surveillance, kind of M2M applications. And we really wanted to take a broader look at enterprise IoT, like industrial IoT, some branch IoT use cases. And that was really the building blocks or the fuel for this new product that we put together, the S400. And the areas that are shaded are really where we think that the S400 is going to shine and really expand some new opportunities, open that up for Ericsson. So we're really excited about this, from light industrial with some hazardous location certifications and ruggedization, as well as some really interesting novel features that we'll dig into a little bit more for some of the other use cases.
Cool. Now, specific to the S400, we're gonna make our little dissolve and move to the actual unit, but what would be some of the highlights you might want to point out that we'll point out on the actual gear?
What really stands out to me for this entry-level product is the fact that it's a Cat 6 modem. This is a mass market M2M IoT router with a Cat 6 modem. It's got Gigabit Ethernet, optional Wi-Fi, it has GPS built in. There's two more features that are really very unique to this platform in the industry. So the first is its modularity, and you can see the three expansion modules on the right side of the screen. At launch, we're going to have a dual Ethernet module. We're going to have a DB9 serial port expansion module, and then finally a 2x10 GPIO module. And so the use cases for each one of those really vary. So with the dual Ethernet, you can have, you know, up to three Ethernet ports on this very small product. If you need serial connectivity, you simply pop in a serial card. If you need more high density GPIO for inputs or outputs control, you can put that into the router as well. And so the product is really modular and very customizable for each and every application out there.
So that's pretty cool. So you can have your, you know, LAN connection or wired connection, if you will. You could have your cellular backup or even cellular as a primary connection, and even a third one if you need the, like a satellite potentially, for instance, and being able to manage all three of those connections right on the router.
Yeah, absolutely. So I was actually meeting with a customer yesterday in a small kiosk, and they had multiple Ethernet devices that needed connectivity. So as opposed to using a third-party Ethernet switch and trying to manage that remotely, Now we have all that built in. And yeah, absolutely. Other use cases, if you have a, you know, an Ethernet connection, a you know, some sort of dedicated connection, and you want to use cellular for failover, or if you want to use cellular for primary and failover to satellite, all of that is baked in capability into this router. So the modularity is really a crucial piece for this. And then at the very bottom of the screen, the very last bullet is the security and the fact that we're launching this product with Secure Connect SASE included in the subscription. So if you have an active subscription for this product, it comes with Secure Connect SASE included. The reason for this was really that IoT is so pervasive and we're taking a different approach that it needs to be secure. And so we're including it with every product that goes out the door.
That's just fantastic. And then a quick one on the size comparisons, but let's see the real thing.
All right, let's dig into it. So in this Indescript box, what we have is the S400. So this Cat 6 router is available in both Wi-Fi and non-Wi-Fi versions. On the antenna side, we have your primary, which is muxed with GPS. You have Wi-Fi, and then you have your secondary cellular. On the side of the product, what we have is a big update to the IBR200. So the S400 has dual SIM cards, which are independently inserted. And then we have the modularity component here. And we'll talk about the modules itself. On the business end, we have our built-in Gigabit Ethernet port. This defaults to a LAN configuration, and it also supports PoE input. So if you need to power the device, we can absolutely support 802.3AF PoE input. We have our standard USB, our 2x2 micro Molex reset button, and then a single LED indicator here. We have our Kensington lock and the beautiful Ericsson logo. When we dig into the box, we have all the accessories you might be looking for. This happens to be one of our international versions. So it's got our power supply, has our clips, and then all of the antennas are included. This little gadget right here is the SIM ejection tool. So everything that somebody needs to install a S400 in the field is included in the box. And that's really one of the small things that makes Ericsson Cradlepoint products just so darned easy, is that everything's included. All right, so let me get this out of the way and let's look at some of the modules here. So the very first module that we're going to look at is the dual Ethernet. So these are two fast Ethernet ports, which are configurable as LAN or WAN independently. The next one, we have our serial port. This is a DB9 RS232 serial port. This can be used for out-of-band management or for serial encapsulation or for SCADA-style applications. Then the final one is the high-density GPIO. This is a 2x10 with a whole variety of different I/O types on board, from inputs to outputs, and they are all configurable.
I don't know if you heard me, Colin, but when you pulled it out, that thing fits right in the palm of your hand.
It is small. It was designed for small cabinets, small enclosures, you know, to take up as little room as required. So we packed a ton of features into this thing, but it's about 4 inches square and about an inch tall.
Wow. And then once you plug it into the network and such, you then would manage it through NetCloud Manager, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So as soon as SIM cards are installed, it connects to NetCloud Manager, downloads the configuration. So as I said, all of the Ethernet ports are LAN, WAN switchable. The serial port, everything, you know, is addressable and configurable through NetCloud.
Nice. Really cool stuff. And it's fun to kind of do a different type of demo video rather than kind of going through a configuration, actually showing the hardware. Because I know from going to trade shows and such, our customers really, really get attached to their hardware and kind of identify, ooh, I got that one right there. So obviously these ruggedized routers just work. I've heard stories where they were out on an oil rig and the person was like, it had dirt, it had oil, it had water spewing everywhere, and the router just worked, which is pretty cool.
That's one of the things that draws me to IoT is just the range of applications that these products get deployed in. Everything from, you know, banking ATMs to video surveillance to drones to offshore oil rigs or wind farms or whatever the case. So it's just so cool to see the variety of technologies that are being incorporated and what's happening to these industries. So
right. And most importantly, being able to secure those connections, because many of those devices might not have inherent security built into them, particularly many of the IoT devices.
A lot of critical infrastructure absolutely doesn't. It's old equipment that just never needed security because it was always isolated. But now we want to connect and control, and that has its own challenges. So again, by including Secure Connect SASE, out of the box, you can have 1, 10, 100, 1,000 S400 routers configured in less than 5 minutes.
Wow.
It's phenomenal.
Yeah, much easier than the old ways, right? Having to fat finger the entire config in a prompt scenario. But appreciate you coming on here, Colin. We'll get you again for the R980. So look for that one coming soon. If you'd like to learn more about the new Cradlepoint routers, particularly the S400, you can certainly visit cradlepoint.com. If you have one of the Cradlepoint routers, leave a comment. We'd love to hear some of your Cradlepoint router stories. I'm sure Colin would love to hear them. And if you enjoyed this video, obviously hit that like, hit that share, hit that subscribe. Cool stuff, Colin. Appreciate your time. So for my pal Colin here, I'm Peter. This is the Ericsson Enterprise Wireless Demo Series. Thanks for watching.